Hello and welcome, I'm Arumba, thank you for joining me. Let's play some Dwarf Fortress 2014 with the newest version of Dwarf Fortress, version R_09R1. So, I had to update my patch because DF hack was causing some instability issues and the game was crashing within the first 30 seconds, which is awesome. It's kind of to be expected, you know. The game itself has just been patched like a month ago. So, if you'd like to see how world generation worked out, you can go check out video number 0, which should be in the playlist right above this video. But let's just get started. So, we're playing as the fortress of Guzrimtar. I had to write this down. We are the castle. We're Simple Castles is the name of our fortress, and our group name is Nilforat, which is the Hammer of Virginity. These were randomly generated names. I did not choose them myself, but they are nonetheless quite comical. So, as I mentioned in video number 0, we are just going to dive in, have some fun, play some Dwarf Fortress, and go from there. I'm not going to be explaining every little thing, but we will, you know, I'll be talking about it. You know how I play. So, let's take a look around the map a bit. Got a river that runs right through the center. It's generally quite flat in the center. The sevens, of course, represent deep water. There's a river right there. Got some minor ponds and lakes and stuff. And our group is right here. We did bring a few things with us. We have, I'm used to being able to click on these things. I had a mod called Mouse Query, but I have to use the keyboard shortcuts here. So we got a stray water buffalo bull, a one-humped camel. It doesn't actually tell me the gender up here in the tooltip, which is kind of irritating. I'm used to being able to see that. K is look. Gotta remember these shortcut keys. What are the other ones? V comes to mind. View units. There we can see the gender. Okay, stray one-humped camel. That little necklace thing actually doubles as a female indicator. And this is a stray water bull male. These guys pulled the wagon for us. We also brought a dog. A couple dogs, actually. We got a male dog and a female dog. A male cat and female cat. A bunch of hens and a rooster. And we've got a few dwarves. Now, we're going to be using just two mods then, since we can't use DF hack. Mod number one is going to be Dwarf Therapist. Very essential, I think, to actually being able to play this game. And as you can hear in the background, we also have Sound Sense, which parses your log file and then plays seasonal music, sound effects, that kind of stuff. Fortunately, this is all open public domain music, and so we should be able to use it just fine on YouTube. Okay, so let's see what we want to do. How long has it actually been since I've played? Now, they've actually, in this major patch, they've changed the way that trees work. You might remember they were like these little itty-bitty tiny saplings, and now they're these monstrous trees that are like 10 Z levels tall. And so when you chop down a tree, you get a ton of wood. But I think that they grow much slower. I actually don't know how they grow. But that's a lot of wood, and we're going up. You can always see the Z level here, 141. So I'm going up, and now we're going down, and if we go down too deep, we can't see anything. But where do we want to start our fortress? We could have a surface entrance, and then build a wall around it. That usually works fairly well. On the other hand, we could just dig our way into a corner. That works well, too. I think we'll go with a surface entrance. Might not be the most dwarf-like, but that seems fine to me. We're nice and close to it. They'll only have to carry up the items about 4 Z levels. And we can create an entrance somewhere around here. And then use this mountain. Or, really, it's more of a hill. We use this hill kind of as the initial staging ground, and then we'll dig straight down. And it will be awesome. Okay, so, let's see. First things first. We've got to zoom in back again a little bit, and designate. We want to dig a downward stairway. How does this work again? Oh, that's right. You can't actually scroll through that list, can you? Oh, gosh. I've got to use all my keyboard shortcuts. This game's going to drive me nuts. All right. Designate up-down stairways. I. We don't want up-down. We just want downward stairway. J. Okay, just make sure I've got my bearings straight. I think I do. I think we're ready. Let's do this. We'll dig a 3x3 stairway. Actually, we'll make it something like that. We'll leave the center hollow. And then one Z level down from there. Now we do want to do up down stairways, which is going to be I. And again, we'll go like that. And then we'll do D for regular mining. And you know what we'll actually do is, can that fit? Oh, beautiful. It can fit perfectly. All right, so we only have one miner right now. Looks like his name is Dishmab. Dishmab Kuboxolam. I wonder what his name means in English. Lanced Nation. Okay. Let's see, who else would be good at being a miner? So we've got Kubok could be a good miner. We'll give him that job as well. And in fact, we can even try running the optimize button. See if that makes any sense. It's only going to give us one miner, though. I don't really like that. Why are there no hauling labors listed here? Oh, I've got the rolls screen. That's why. It would give us two haulers, one miner. You know what? Maybe we could get away with just one miner for now. Let's just go with the one. F1 to go home, and we're going to want to designate some trees. We'll chop down a tree or two right near the entrance. I don't actually remember if I got any gatherers. I probably should have. I really don't know. Let's see. Butchering. They've changed the way that this is all grouped now. There's more colors. Confuses me. Gathering. Cheese making, milking, brewing, plant gathering. We have no plant gatherer. Okay, well, who would be good at that? Plant gathering. Called herbalism here. We've got one guy, the farmer. Farmer cheesemaker. You can now gather plants and thresh them as well. That'll work out okay. Oh, you're also a stone crafter. You've got lots of skills. Alright, designate plants, get that person busy. Probably not going to be a terrible number of plants out there. What are these little things anyway? Foxtail millet plants and foxtail millet leaves. Very nice. Purple aromanths. Leeks. Cool. Now, we want to also pasture the animals up near where the entrance will be. So we will create a zone, I think that's what it's called, if I remember correctly. Is it a zone or is it a pasture? It's not a stockpile. Well, let's just make a zone and see what happens. If we call this a zone. Yes, indeed, it is a zone that we want. So we're going to call this a pen or pasture. Set pen and pasture information, and for now we can navigate this list. Let's get the three hens, the rooster, and the water buffalo, and the one humped camel up here. And that's about it, really. Cats and dogs can go wherever the heck they want. I don't really care. What else do we want to do? Those are pretty much the defaults, right? You know what we'll want to do is create a stockpile and have people drag the stuff over. So pile. And we'll just say, bring all this stuff up here. And how do you modify that again? Q. It's currently an animal stockpile. We want to change settings. We want to enable all. Just bring all the things here. So if you have nothing to do, bring it up here. Okay, so we'll let the game run now. Unpause, yay! Only took 10 minutes, and it's raining. So the little derps are just going to like bring bags and yarn and stuff up here. Oh, you know what I do want to do, though, is I want to disable hauling on the miner. Because I don't want him to do anything except for dig. Where is our little miner anyway? Dwarves don't like the rain, you know. They're going to want to get into that soft soil because they can. Gosh, I'm so used to being able to click. Just let me click. I really want Moss Query back. Alright, stairs have been dug out. That's good. He's working hard. Or hardly working. One of the two. Once he gets this whole row dug out, we'll move the stockpile inland. Apparently, what is that? A different type of soil? Or is it just wet? Ash roots. Oh, it's roots to the tree. Cool. That's new. It doesn't affect the way that the ground looks, does it? I wonder. Man, just having one miner. It's not very many. Go to our home location. In fact, we should probably set up a shortcut key to take us to the entrance. Right about here. Probably be good. Maybe here, actually. To do that, we want to go to capital H. Again, then we want to go down to hotkey 2 is F1. Two, Z, escape. And actually, we can rename it too. F2, change name, entrance. And then F1, N, we'll rename gate to embark. That's where we started the embark. So now we can tab back and forth between the two points. What are these little things? They look like little rats. Those can't be rats. I think those are crutches or something. Splints. They look like rats. The game reuses some textures. It's fine. That's just one of the things that it does. So what do we have in this structure? We've got tons of rum. We brought a whole bunch of milk. I brought a ton of donkey milk. Donkey's milk barrel. There's like a lot of milk because we're going to turn it into cheese. And we're going to make cheese biscuits. People are going to like it. Looks like we need a larger stockpile. We can start moving stuff in, but it's not going to be very efficient at first. It's fine. Actually, you know what we should do? Is remove designation. Remove that one. And then... Can I copy this one? Go ahead and let him use wear barrels. I don't remember how to do it. Custom stockpile. Custom settings. Alright, well, we'll just create a custom stockpile. I could swear there's a way to copy an existing... That might be a feature that I'm just not used to, though. Or that was like in a mod or something. It's not available. But we'll learn to get around good old-fashioned Dwarf Fortress without the mods. And so we've moved a new stockpile indoors, and they're just moving stuff around. Now what we want to do is we want to... take the stockpile and say give to a pile or workshop, and then move the cursor to the warp pile you want to give to. We want to give it to this one, and then say enter. Alright, so they'll move stuff, generally try to bring it inland in a bit. Let's create a wood stockpile as well, just like a separate wood one. Like here. And that means that we can go to this stockpile, settings, and then remove wood. Same thing with this one. I imagine that this thing is going... Yeah, TSK means task. We're seeing that actually get stuff being brought in. It's good. They're moving stuff in. We're happy. What are the dwarves doing? No idlers. That makes me happy. Oh, look at that. The different trees have different types of blossoms. Hazel tree twigs. Pollen catkins. Cool. I have to say that that's a cool feature. Meanwhile, the camel and the yak, or whatever it is, just wandering around. We need to make some nest boxes for the chickens. We should also probably start building some really basic workshops, like, say, a carpenter's workshop. Just stuff so that we can get some basic things being built, like a couple wheelbarrows, that kind of thing. That's a carpenter's workshop. What else do we want? We need a, I think a farmer's workshop is used to turn milk into cheese. I'm not sure, though. Naturally, we're going to want all these things indoors, but let the game run. Let's read dwarves. Current job, all. Basically, everyone's just moving stuff. They're just storing stockpiles. Isn't there a better way to see this? Sort by current job. Here we go. Yeah, I like that better. And let's go to options, grid options, cell size. I want to reduce that. I want to be able to see every item. While having it organized like that. Okay. Now, what's up with this? Is this moss already growing? Sparse wig sawgrass. Sparse blue sedge. It's all gonna turn ugly. Oh well, it is what it is. Fortunately, he's getting quite a bit of mining experience working on all this soft soil. So by the time we get our one miner working, we started him off at level 2. He's already level 5. So he'll get quite a bit better. Get more and more skilled at mining. He's already up to 84. Like, with it, he's good. He's pretty decent. A little bit more stuff to bring in. And it looks like no one has decided to any workshop farming, any carpentry. No one's working on that stuff yet. Lazy little bastards. So eager to haul things around. Hauling is not really high priority anyway. Alright, I think it's time we change the settings on this stockpile. We actually don't want to bring, like, corpses and refuse. It's easier to set everything up. Am I just, like, going through and telling them to bring everything? Bring all the things! Got a meat barrel. I need a kitchen. Build, workshop, kitchen. Kitchen is Z. I just want a kitchen. Something that can be used to build things. Okay, well, I'm going to wrap it up here and take a break. But in the next video, hopefully our glorious fortress will continue to grow. What is our fortress called again? Simple Castles. The outpost of Guzrimtar. So, see you again in the next video, everyone. Thanks for watching. See you soon.